Welcome dear learners to my YouTube channel Learn with Shivi. I am Shivi Gupta and today we are going to read and understand a poem named The Kite. It is written by Harry Benn and it is published in the book Honeysuckle by NCERT. Now before we begin reading the poem, let me remind you of our rules. The first rule is sit with your book and a pencil ready along with you so that you can keep marking all the difficult words. The second rule is feel free to use a dictionary whenever required. And the third rule is watch the video again till you get a clear idea about what the poet is trying to tell you. And the last one, please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Learn with Shivi. So let's get started. The Kite by Harry Benn. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail, then soars like a ship with only a sail. As over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows and its wings fill and up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new, but a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. Okay, so let's start understanding the poem. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. So the poet over here is trying to tell you that how beautiful a new kite looks in the sky. When the sky is clear and your kite is just soaring high and high in the sky. So if you look at it, you feel such wonderment. You are so amazed by the look of it that you are just happy looking at it in the sky, just looking at it soaring high, and you are just filled with awe for it, right? So the poet over here says, with a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail. So what is the poet now trying to tell you? The poet is now trying to discuss with you, to tell you about the movement of a kite. I am sure you all must have either flown a kite or have seen somebody flying a kite, right? So you would have noticed about the movement of a kite. When it goes up, when it goes down, when it stays at rest, you would have noticed different movements of the kite, right? And the same movements are told to you by the poet. I am repeating the lines. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new, with a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail, then soars like a ship with only a sail. Now, what is the poet trying to do over here? The poet is trying to compare the movement of a kite with the movement of a ship. Okay, so the poet is using a simile over here. He's trying to compare the two movements. The poet is saying that like a ship, on its sides, when it soars high on when a ship soars high on sails due to the high tides, the similar movement is felt when the kite is in the sky and it is soaring high because of the high winds. So the poet goes on to say, as over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls. The poet is trying to say that it is all the blessing of the high tides that makes the ship soar high on water, right? Similarly, it is all the blessings of the wind that makes the kite fly higher and higher in the sky, right? And it says that it climbs to the crest. It reaches the topmost point. It reaches the highest point in the sky with the help of the gust of wind and the pulls and the continuous pulling of the string by the flyer, right? Because of the continuous force, you would have also noticed when the kite is going high and high, the to take it at a further highest point, the flyer, it just keeps pulling the string so that it gets a good stretch and the kite is able to go higher, right? Then seems to rest as wind falls. But when all of a sudden at times it happens that the wind is not always flowing in a very steady manner, right? Sometimes it comes at a point where the kite has to rest. And because of this rest position, the kite is not able to move further in the sky, and because of which the poet has to, the flyer has to then adjust its string, right? When string goes slack, you wind it back. So what the poet says that whenever the string of the kite goes in a curved position because of the low wind, what does the flyer do? The flyer winds it back. You would have seen that there is a roller sort of a thing in the hands of a flyer which has the string attached to it and the kite, right? So the flyer, it just starts pulling the string back. He starts rolling it back so that the kite which has whose string has started to slack does not fall down further. And run until a new breeze blows. And the flyer keeps doing it until a new breeze blows, until a new gust of wind is felt by the kite and the flyer, and the kite starts going ahead again. And its wings fill and up it goes. And the wings of the kite, they fill up with the wind, and the wind helps push the kite further higher in the sky. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. So the poet is again emphasizing on how beautiful a kite looks when it is soaring high in the sky, in the blue clear sky. What beauty does a kite hold? But a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. But oh God, now the poet is trying to tell you that, see, okay, the kite looks beautiful and everything, but at one point its beauty, its grace in the sky, it just gets lost because when the wind falls down or somebody cuts your kite, what happens is that it tends to get stuck on a branch of a tree, or maybe it falls down or it gets stuck somewhere else, and that is when the kite loses all its beauty. It starts to just fade away. The kite just starts looking ugly because of the torn layer that it has now because of all the crashing, right? So the poet says that, see, the kite in the sky, it looks very beautiful when it is soaring higher and higher, and how the flyer has to put in efforts to keep it steady in the sky and to keep moving it further ahead and try and reach the highest limits of the sky. But it is beautiful till that time only. But when it falls down due to some or the other reason, it becomes a bit torn, the kite loses all its beauty. So this was all about the poem. I hope you've understood the entire poem very nicely now. If you have a doubt somewhere, please watch the video again so as to get a better understanding of the poem. Also, I'll be putting a link of a downloadable worksheet of this particular poem. And you can also go through the links of previous poems and chapters that we've done together if you have missed on something, or if you want to revise. Okay, so this was all for today's class, and we'll meet in the next class. Till then, take care, stay home, stay safe, and bye-bye.